Why was it so important for you to really dive in and become part of the TikTok community? Because we see you making TikToks with all the other TikTok stars out there.
But it wasn't important, right? It has nothing to do with importance. It was just about having fun. It wasn't like, yo, I need to get in when the TikTok vibe. Nah, it was like, this app is fun, and this is the first app that, like, I feel like I could be myself. You know what I'm saying? I feel like Instagram is just, it's just real superficial, and people would, like, try to act like somebody that they're not, taking photos whenever they're doing something amazing. And TikTok is a totally different vibe where it's like, you know, it's cool to be you. You know what I'm saying? It's cool to have fun. It's cool to make fun of yourself. And it, that's just my vibe, right? Like, if it's not fun for me, like what's the use? You know, I mean, I'm 30 years old. You know what I'm saying? I'm like at the point in my life, I've been very successful. I don't need to work another day in my life, right? I mean, so it's all about things that are going to elevate me mentally and things that are going to make me have a good time.
Is this the most fun you've been having in your
career? Oh, absolutely, because I've been at the crib, man. Like, boy, like for me to like get out and go do a show, boy, they gotta bring the big bag, boy, because the crib is lit. Like, I'm like, people get to do this, like wake up in their own bed all the time. Oh, nah, I need this too.
And everybody really comes to you. Like, you've set it up like where all the people, even to collaborate, they come to you. They come to your content factory.
Yeah, I mean, you know, I mean, there's no other reason than just like here's the vibe.
I don't know. You got James Charles to your house. That's a big get. Like, that's a big YouTuber on the block. I believe, you know, maybe an iconic YouTuber, I think, is the right way to describe him.
Word up. Yeah, I mean, it's all kinds of people come through here, man. And I think it's a wonderful thing to merge the world and to let them know how important that they are. I think for so long, influencers got the short end of the stick. All of these musicians, you know, they only try to use them when it's time to drop a record. Like, I try to, like, invite these guys out, you know, to just to have, like hibachi dinners, you know what I'm saying? Like, these are influential people that do incredible things, and they always get the short end of the stick, you know? I'm personally tired for them. You know what I'm saying? They don't even got to say nothing, because I'll say it for them. All of these labels, all of these companies come to them all the time, and they're underpaid, even though they get paid a lot of money at this point. Like, they're making millions of dollars, yeah? But, like, still underpaid, because when a company buys an ad on a commercial, they're getting less viewership than when they hire these influencers. Like, these influencers are getting millions upon millions and millions of views on these ads. You know what I'm saying? And these companies are still paying a little less than they would if they were, doing a commercial.
How do you see yourself within the influencer community? Are you a godfather? Are you a mentor? Are you a big brother? Like, what's the vibe here? Do you give them advice?
Yeah, man. I'd like to be it all, man. Like, I mean, like whatever's clever. Like, what I tell people is, like, utilize me, because, like, I am a tool, and I know that I'm a tool, and I know I can help you in a lot of ways. So the people that I'm close to, like, that are around me, the people that I know and love, but also these influencers, like, you can utilize me, and it's cool. Like, I don't need nothing back. You know what I'm saying? It's not that kind of vibe, but like allow me to be, like, you know, a backbone for you. Allow me to be a voice for you. Like, anything that you need, like allow me to be that.
You've been through a lot, dude. You've seen a lot. Like, it's
for sure.
Wisdom.
And you know, a lot of these artists are, I mean, influencers are trying to do other things in their life as well. It's not just about TikTok. It's not just about Instagram. I mean, they have other goals as well.
What is the next platform for a lot of these influencers? Like, Vine was to YouTube. TikTok is to what?
I think TikTok is actually an extension of Vine, if anything. I think it's like the Vine on steroids. It's the Vine that never made it. The Vine that exploded
It's what Vine could have been, yeah.
Yeah, it's what Vine could have been, but like it's just done so well. I mean, even just how it's laid out, the culture of it, it feels like a community. Yeah, you know, it, like even like all of these influencer houses, like how things are just kind of organically happening. You know, you could do reality shows from these houses. I mean, you know, you have all of these influential kids in one house. I mean, it's crazy. The power in TikTok is really crazy. I mean, you see with the music industry, the music industry is literally ran by TikTok.
Do you think the next major pop star could also be a TikTok star? And I'm not saying like a song that is given to TikTok to blow up. I'm saying, could the next big pop star emerge as from the TikTok creator pool? You know what I'm saying?
I mean, of course. I mean, Shawn Mendes from Vine.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I mean, we don't see it all the time, but it is possible. You know, Justin Bieber from YouTube. You know what I'm saying?
Platform has their one.
I don't know if Instagram had their one.
No, I'll get back to you.
I mean, you do see a lot of these TikTok stars releasing music. I mean, Dixie D'Amelio released a song today. Jaden Hostler has music coming out. So these guys are trying to transition into different platforms.
The thing is, with those other platforms, I don't think we've ever seen these big of stars emerge.
Yeah.
Like, I mean, like Charlie and Addison and Dixie, like these are like real powerhouses. You know, like when was the last time you seen an Instagrammer, like someone that just did Instagram, have 70 million followers? Like, that never existed. That was never a Vine thing. That was never, you know what I'm saying? Like, this is a whole different kind of star. This is a whole different kind of power. You know what I'm saying?
So it's like, crazy, because we'll interview like the Jonas Brothers or another big musician, and then we'll interview a TikTok star, and the TikTok star's views just blow them out of the water.
I'm sure. Yeah. I'm sure. And you're seeing it translate too. They're translating to Instagram. I mean, it's a real thing. But the world is slowly paying attention. It's still behind in a lot of ways, but people are catching up.
But TikTok is mainstream America, dude. TikTok is in everybody, everything platform, and it's in places big and small like we've never seen. I think Vine for a while was like, you know, very college centric and like it had its like click communities, whereas TikTok is coast to coast, which is why we're seeing 75 million followers on a single human being. I mean, those are crazy numbers.
Well, Jason, how do you feel about this? The other day I was thinking that like these TikTok houses, like the Hype House, those are almost like the new boy bands. Like they're like the new One Direction.
Oh yeah, I totally agree with that. I totally agree with that. I mean, you can see the pandemonium. You can feel it. You know, the waiting outside of their houses. You know, it's like it's the similar vibe. It's for sure that.